If you're not following me on Instagram, please do follow, because we are uploading many behind the scene pictures and videos there.
Hit that subscribe button and bell icon so you never miss an update from Neela Bakore Tutorials.
We have talked about the reasons why biodiversity is lost. Now, there are two more aspects which we need to talk about. One is conservation. Why should we conserve? And second is how to conserve. So, let us first talk about why to conserve biodiversity. There are various reasons, and all these reasons have been grouped into three categories. The first is a very narrow vision, or it is known as narrowly utilitarian argument in support of the reasons why should we conserve. The second is a broad spectrum view. It is called broadly utilitarian view. And the third is the ethical view. Ethical reason or ethical view. So now let us talk about these three in little more detail. What is meant by narrowly utilitarian? Utility point of view, it is a narrow vision view. If something is required for us, then we should conserve it. So if it is required for me, for us, then we are going to conserve. We are not thinking about what is going to happen after 500 years or thousands of years. Broadly utilitarian is like a wider perspective, that our future generations should also be able to get fresh environment and clean water and all those things. So that would come under the broad view, and ethical is something different. So narrow spectrum says that whatever we need, we should be able to conserve that. What all things do we get from this biodiversity? So let us start with wood, timber, and this is for construction purposes. We also get wood, which is used for paper making. Then there are some plant products which are used for various industries like tannin, resins, perfumes. All these things, or most of these things which we are using, they are coming from the plants. So fibers, various kinds of fibers. So this is because we need them. We need this construction material, we need tannins, we need these fibers. That is why we should be conserving the biodiversity. There is an approximate estimation that about 25% of the medicines which we are using are from plants. So when we are getting benefited directly, then we should be conserving it. This is one view. But even if we are able to concentrate on this, we would still be able to conserve biodiversity, because there are so many things which we are getting from these plants. This is like the direct benefit. The indirect benefit is, because of these plants, we are getting oxygen to breathe. Because of these plants, who are able to synthesize their own food, we are able to eat. So this is like a very narrow spectrum view. Broad spectrum view is, or broad utilitarian view is, like future generations. Amazon forest is known as the lung. Amazon forest is called the lung of the planet or earth. So we should be conserving it so that our future generations are able to get the clean air. I'll give you one example. There are certain animals which have become extinct. Tigers are becoming extinct. In the previous video, we talked about bird, like dodo got extinct. So how do we learn about these animals or plants which are becoming extinct? Suppose the tigers, they become extinct. There are very few tigers remaining, and if we don't conserve them, they're going to become extinct. So what exactly are we going to show to our children, our future generations? We will have nothing but the pictures that there was an animal and it would look like this. There were stripes on the body and these patterns, and they were this kind of animal. We would have just stories to tell. But if those animals exist, if we are able to conserve them, the future generations would actually get to see those animals and understand what exactly is happening. They will be able to admire the nature. Now, in broadly utilitarian view, there is one more view that it is a very good feeling when you're like walking in a garden, you're walking in the forest, so that chirping of birds and that noise, little noise which you get there in the forest, that is very soothing. That should be available for the future generations. So that is the broadly utilitarian view of, or reason why we should be conserving biodiversity. Now comes the third one, ethical. Ethical means the morals, the values. We humans, other animals, plants of every kind are on this planet Earth. Or in other words, we can say that Earth belongs to all of these organisms, including us. So what right do we have to kill them or modify them? So there should be proper or equal distribution of all these plants. So this is basically talking about the moral values, and these are called the bioethical values. Bioethics, or the morals that Earth belongs to all animals and plants, and we as humans do not have the right to change anything in the nature, and that is why we should conserve it. So be it a narrow utilitarian view for ourselves, be it a little wider, broad spectrum that our future generations also get to see everything, be it the moral values or bioethical values. For all these three reasons, we should be conserving the biodiversity. So we got the answer for why should we conserve biodiversity. Now, after we have understood that yes, it is important and we need to conserve, the next question is going to be how to conserve this biodiversity. That we will take up in the next video.